Let's finally find the answers to all this riddle and cycle babble. Yep, Achilles' grave. Amazing. Find the truth through the past. By actually going
All right,
back to
time
the
to
past.
See what's inside.
Not quite. We still need to get the place powered up.
Find the remaining pedestals and plug in the power sources.
I'm on it.
Okay. Let's do this again. I will find the rest. What opened up before? Something opened up. I think this... No, that wasn't it. What opened up? I think it was this, wasn't it? No, it wasn't that. That's what we're trying to open up. But something opened... oh, this had to be it. This is it. Right here. That sucked. Let me go back up there. Didn't this open up? Yep. All right.
A new world approached. One that was dark and cold. It would consume us. For we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice. Not to save us all.
The hell?
So we sought to change what
Sickness,
we were.
Sickness, I guess.
In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita, my husband, my love.
Hmm.
In the end, it changed him. Ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive, but his mind became brittle to the touch.
Huh.
He begged me for release.
Is that the end?
For days, for weeks, for months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us.
Oh, killed him. Okay. Now, let's see. Looks like we gotta go up. Okay. Let's go up. Yep. Now what? Ah, here we go. Guess I have to go. Yep, I had to go over here. What the hell? Okay. Now we're going. Okay, now what? Up, next file.
What is consciousness but a series of electrical impulses? And the body, a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles into dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced with something stronger, something better? So we forged a new vessel, one that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered, though, were they right to turn away?
Huh? Anybody following this? So I'm having problems trying to follow this story. I'll just keep climbing until I figure out what the hell's going on. Oh crap, now what? I don't know where I'm going. Oh, I guess I'm going there. Be it. Alright, hopefully this powers everything up. Do it. Let's go in. I guess I'll talk to him.
I've been poking around a bit. Did you know there are machines down here that make, well, mana?
Wizard mana or biblical mana?
What do you think? Biblical, of
mana.
Course. The Greeks called it ambrosia. The Indians, amrit or soma. Most cultures around the world refer to a divine food, though I'd say its taste is anything but.
You ate something that came out of a 75,000-year-old machine.
And I live to tell the tale.
So? What did it taste like?
Cardboard. Taste of cardboard. Hardly the stuff of legends, though.
Mm.
I wonder if the first
rice cakes. Gotcha.
Taste differently than we...
Now, what do I do here? Well, now what? I guess I'll talk to Dad.
Did Vidic put you in an animus when you were at Abstergo? They'd be able to search your memories and track you back here.
Oh, they definitely tried, but I made things difficult for them. You can resist, you can cloud up the transmission, or just refuse to move. Eventually, they would have gotten what they needed, but it still would have taken them weeks.
Vidic threatened to put me in a coma once.
It would have made you more pliable. But if the user isn't engaged, it's a mess. I know they've been working on ways to extract memories and let others sift through those memories. Maybe they're even analyzing mine right now. Maybe they'll find us. I don't know. What I do know is that we've got to get through that door.
Yeah. I should probably get back into the Animus.
Back into the Animus? Huh. Okay. I didn't know that. Good thing he told me that.
Guess this is it.
We're right behind you.
Alright, let's do it. What are we doing? Did he say go back to the... whatever. Maybe I should just find out. These guys are taking too long walking. Yep. So that's the key. That should open it up.
Moment of truth.
Let's do it. Let's finally find the answers to all this riddle and psychobabble, scientific crap. I can't understand what the hell's going on, but you know, maybe this will clear everything up. Can we prevent the apocalypse? Okay. Let's go. What the hell's going on?
Yes.
Why is it the camera just went widescreen?
Here, at last.
You know our story now. Of how we tried. Of how we failed. All our hopes extinguished. Save one. Your touch. A spark. A spark to save the world.
Wait! Do not
touch the pedestal.
What
the hell is this?
Minerva?
Oh, Minerva.
You. But how? You left! You destroyed the device!
Did you think there was only one?
What the hell is going on here?
You must not free her.
What the hell?
Free her?
What the hell's going on here?
She dwells within these walls, awaiting release. I will explain. While we worked to save the world, she sought instead to conquer it. She used our machines to set her plans in motion.
Numbers.
There is a pattern to existence. To comprehend the calculations is to tame time.
This is all a trick to free her.
And so I built the eye to aid us. But she turned towards her own ends. When we discovered her treachery, we
she killed her husband.
And then we left. But first we called to you that you might
she wanted to
again.
Be here.
We
oh,
thought it would
shit.
Be safe with her gone. Now I see we were deceived. She survived, she endured, and then she began to work. For centuries, Tinny and I walked the world, hoping to rekindle the spark of civilization. We shared what we knew as best we could. We were not the only ones, but for all the power we wrought, still death would claim us. But before it did, I would have one last look to know if we had succeeded.
That's how you're here now?
I had hoped you might find this place. And finish our work. But it is too late. You and the Templars have squabbled over our refuse. You have wasted centuries. And so you have lost your chance. You cannot hope to stop the end now, Desmond. Only to survive.
She's lying!
What?
Only touch the pedestal and the world will be saved.
Better the world burn than she be loosed upon it.
Is that
what?
So?
Oh, shit. What the hell's going on here?
Understand. It is complicated. It is...
Show me.
So I had to save the world.
If you heed Minerva, the sun will have its way. The ground will crack and spit fire into the skies. All the world will burn. But this does not end the world. Merely heralds its arrival. Darkness follows.
The apocalypse.
Then you emerge, resolving to lay a foundation that such a tragedy does not befall the world again. You will become a symbol to those who survive. Hope, knowledge, determination. Huh. You will inspire them to rebuild.
So he would rebuild this civilization.
Once more. And as the world heals, so too will humanity. But you are just a man. Frail and mortal. You pass from the world, leaving behind only a memory. A legacy. you will be remembered first as a hero, later
heed
as a
these
legend,
words and you'll be
and
saved
time, as a god.
Heed these words
the
or perish as a heretic.
To have written words that meant well and see them made wicked and unwise. What was meant to encourage life, used instead to justify taking it. And so now you see that what was shall be again. So tell me, how is this better?
But then what will Tania do?
She would sacrifice you, sacrifice the world, for no other reason than to deny me vindication.
They will enslave your kind, Desmond. Is this not why you fight? Is this not why you came here? To ensure more than just your race's future, but its freedom?
What
How's
future?
It free?
What freedom? Billions dead and the whole cycle begun anew?
Yeah,
this
that don't make no
has
sense.
Been nothing but heartache and horror since we left it.
Our gift to them, and you'd see it all returned.
Enough!
You must not do this.
Whatever Juno's planning, however terrible it might seem today, we'll find a way to stop it. But the alternative, what you want, there's no hope there.
Yeah, exactly. Why would I want to destroy the world? Destroyed.
It will happen in an instant. There will be no pain.
You mustn't.
It's done, Minerva. The decision's made.
Yeah, it makes no sense.
Then the consequences of this mistake are yours to live and to die with.
You need to go. All of you. Now. Get as far away from here as you can.
Come with us. We'll find another way.
There isn't time.
The hell?
You know it's true.
He's gonna sacrifice himself?
I need to do this now. So go. Go!
But I don't get it. If this is exactly what they wanted to do, why the Templar also wanted it? If there was really no choice.
Never seen anything like this before. Eyewitnesses describe electrical storms and erratic displays of unusual weather. Residents are being asked to remain inside and wait for geological surveys are now reporting seismic activity throughout the Ring of Fire. Northeastern Canada is said to be experiencing the largest... On record, satellites and transformers are failing as the flare increases in intensity. Worldwide reports of blackouts and seems to be receding. Residual seismic and volcanic activity is being reported, but nothing approaching earlier levels. Obviously, it'll be a while before experts are able to assess the full extent of the damage caused by today's event.
Huh.
But it appears the worst is behind us. We'll be sure to bring you more as this story develops.
What?
It is done. The world is saved. You played your part well, Desmond. But now... Now it's time that I play mine.
What? What the hell is going on? What did that mean? So Desmond sacrifices his life to save the world, but they cause some natural disasters. And now she's gonna come back and take over. What the hell? What's going on? How dare they leave a cliffhanger like that? It doesn't matter. it really doesn't matter. So I have conflicting... issues with this game. At first, yes, I did enjoy it. It was fun. There was a couple of good parts. You know, it's fun. you know, running around the forest. I didn't do much of the hunting because, you know, it doesn't seem to be worth it. There's a lot of stuff that you could do. I granted that. The story was pretty good. But there's just something about it left me, you know, like it felt like something was missing. It didn't feel epic. I mean, I understand, you know, the story was, you know, this is a global you know, catastrophe that happened. But there wasn't that sense of epicness that this game was trying to draw you in, you know, trying to understand what was the story. I don't know. I'm trying to explain it. It's tough. The gameplay was fine. I mean, it's Assassin's Creed. It felt like I was playing, you know, the old games. It's the same way. It felt the same. I think that's what it was. You get tired of it. It's the same thing. You're running around, jumping, you know, dodging. You're climbing trees. Big deal. It's the same thing. There was no reason to climb buildings. Buildings are not high enough. What's the point of climbing buildings? I'm always on the ground. And if you get up on the building, well, guess what? Soldiers spot you like that instantly. What's the point? There's no reason to climb buildings. So that aspect is gone. That whole sense of scope is gone. I mean, it's big world. This is, you know, you had Boston. You had the frontier. You had New York City. Well, New York town. But they didn't seem different. There was nothing different about it. Boston was a smaller version of New York town. The New York town still had small buildings. There was nothing that felt like it was a different part. It was the same. It felt the same. And the frontier was great at first. I liked it, but it just felt empty. I understand there was no people, you know, the hunting aspect of it. Big deal. You skinned some animals. There was no reason for it. I'm gonna talk about the side missions because you know, there is a ton of side missions that some of them I didn't do. Like the homestead missions, which pretty much was you had to go recruit people to live near your homestead to help you out, to give you resources to put for that really stupid accounting book, that ledger thing that was really stupid. I mean, you had to craft things using using your guys that you recruited, your traders, and they make the resources, they craft it, and then you put it in a convoy, you send it off to merchants, and you sell it. That's how you made your money through them, by that way. Or you use it to craft you don't really make things. It's just what I'm trying to say. You don't really make things on your own. You have to find these people who are all over the land. And you save them. Pretty much you got to save them. You got to save them from some kind of situation. Whether they're being attacked, harassed, drowning. You know, one in the waterfall. The guy was drowning. You had to save him. And then you got lumber. Woo, whoopee. Yeah, very nice. What was it? The liberation missions. There was nothing interesting about it. All right, so you go in, you attack more guys, you free everybody. Whoop-de-doo, you've been doing that the whole story mission. What's the difference? In older games, you were recruiting assassins. They had that here also. They did have that. I tried it a little bit off on my own, but it just was the same thing. It's pretty much you send the guy over different lands, and they come back and give you money. That's all it was. That's it. It was a contract, but you don't see them doing it. So it was like a mini game kind of thing. You said, oh, here, put your guy, you're going to send them off to a land. He's got to assassinate this guy. You got your risks, and you got your time, how long it takes him, and hopefully he survives. They did that with Brotherhood, with Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, which was good. I liked it. I kind of liked it. But I didn't feel like doing it again. Why would I want to do that again? It made no sense. The one side mission I did enjoy was the naval battles. I gotta say, the naval battles were interesting. They were fun. Epic. You want to talk about epic? That was epic. I mean, going out to sea and shooting boats with cannons and whatever those little squiggy things, the bullets. That was fun. That was a lot of fun. They had some here in the story a little bit, but it was mostly side missions, and you did it, you know. It was quick, though. I mean, you know, you go in, you fight the sea, you know. It was short but sweet. That's what that was. That was short but sweet. There was enough that you didn't get bored of it. And you went out, you did it. That was great. I liked that. I really did. The story was good. I gotta say, though, there was a lot of anticlimactic parts. And here's where I'm gonna go. Here's what I mean. On the trailer, you see yourself fighting a battle, and you're like, oh yeah, all right, cool. We're gonna get into the battle. We're gonna finally fight troops, you know, left and right, just go and knock them out, and we're gonna fight this war. But it wasn't about the war. In one instance, you're telling guys, you're giving them orders at a battle, I think a Battle of Concord. You're giving them orders to shoot, you know, like, oh, here comes an approaching army. Fire. You know, oh, look, they're coming closer. Shoot them. At that time, I was just like annoyed. I was like, why are you not shooting them? Just shoot them. They're right there. They're coming right towards you. Why do I have to give you orders? Just do it. Just shoot them. And let me go into the battle and let me fight these guys while you're shooting them. That would have been cool. I mean, they're shooting the soldiers, and you're going in there right in the middle of the battle and fighting these guys left and right. Probably go after the commander. There was another battle where I gotta admit, this was kind of cool. You were actually going into the battle. A large platoon in the background, and you had to run in between trees and rocks to try to get to the commander. I gotta admit, that was cool. That was actually cool. It was frustrating at first because, you know, you get hit three times and you're done. You're dead, pretty much. So you had to get there, you know. And it's like maybe five different rocks or trees. And you had to, you know, try to get your way over to the cliff, which was fine. I didn't mind that at all. That was fine. The last battle, which was a cannon. And let me say, this had to be the dullest mission. Because all you were doing, aiming a cannon at defenseless soldiers. I mean, there's soldiers coming up, and you're aiming the cannon. And you must have done this 10, 15 times or something like that. Fire. Just try to deplete their time. It took 3 minutes, but that's all you were doing. You were firing a cannon. Cool. I don't mind firing cannon, you know. Once in a, you know, three times would have been nice. But they didn't change it up. That's all it was. The Battle of Monmouth, whatever the hell it was. Guys were getting closer, and you were firing cannons. Big deal. Okay. But I didn't need to do that 10 or 15 times. You know, it didn't make sense to me. And then the battle between... finally, the son and the father. They fight. Oh, finally. This is it. We're going to finally fight the father. We're gonna do sword battles. We're going to do, you know, sword play. You know, dodging things. The fort is getting attacked. You got fire coming from the shores. You got you know, soldiers in the fort, and you're in the middle, and it's just between you and father. And finally, we get to do it. And what do we have to do? Quick time events. Yep, we drag them All we gotta do is pretty much just drag him over to a place where he will get knocked out, and then that's pretty much what it was. You just dragged him over to a barrel or to a canyon. I said this before. And you just knock him out. Did this three times. And that was it. You did this three times. You brought him over to get him knocked out. And what did you do? You killed him with a hidden blade, which would have been fine if we had a long, epic battle. But it wasn't. All we did was drag him over to hit barrels. We pushed him into a barrel. We pushed him into a cannon. That's how you knock out Father. This big, highly trained assassin, pretty much. He is an assassin, even though he's with the Templar. He's your equal, almost. You trained, to be able to fight this guy. And you push him into barrels. That was it? That's the whole fight between son and dad? Father and son? This is the epic battle. And then at the end with Charles Lee, this guy killed your mother. Let's go run after him. Let's go get him. Run through a flaming boat. Let's go get him. Here comes the battle. Oh no, we've fallen into a hole. Are you kidding me? And then what happens? You shoot him. Ah, are you kidding me? These two were supposed to be the biggest climax of the whole game. This is why you played it. And it just felt empty. I think that is the reason this disappointed a lot of gamers. I haven't read a lot of reviews, but I've heard that, people were disappointed with this. Now, I might have gone with the mindset that maybe this was going to disappoint me, but I kept playing it until I was like, oh, this is good, it's good, it's good. But then towards the end, you just felt like, I'm being let down here. What is going on? And then the story between Desmond, I got to understand. Right now, I still don't understand what happened. I might have to go back and read some text or something. Maybe go on the internet and find out what the hell was going on. This is why the Templars wanted it? Why we fought the Aspergo, whatever, Asparagus, whatever they call them, to because of this? I would have been glad to let them deal with it. Be like, oh, you got to sacrifice yourself in order to save the world. Let them do it. What's the difference? You don't do it, you do it. It wouldn't have made a difference. The end of the world was not going to happen. The sun wasn't going to come in. This is not about, what is it, the Mayan calendar or anything like that? We're worried because of these stupid ancient civilizations. They wanted to take over? They tricked you into doing this. And once you find out about it, you're going to go kill yourself? Even though you don't know what was going to happen? You say, oh, it might happen? It's going to happen in the near future? We don't know that. I would have gone, be like, what? You want me to kill myself? To save the world? From what? Nothing's happening. I'm going to go back to Aspergo, Astergo, whatever his name is, and be like, listen, guys, here's the Apple of Eden. You want it? I don't care. You want to kill people? Whatever. Here's the power. You want it? Here's the key. This is the key. Pretty much I would just give him the key. Here's the key, the little amulet. Go find out for yourself. By the way, there's the tunnel right there. Go do it. And, figure out for yourself what you want to do. Because right now, the world doesn't look like it's going to end. There's no indication that the sun was going to burn us alive. So, why am I doing this?
I've done this for, what? Three different generations? I was inside the Animus for three different guys? And this is why? I would have been like, here, I found it. I found it for you guys. Here you go. I would have sent it in a nice little envelope, put it in there, and be like, hey, here you go. Enjoy. Why am I doing this? What was the point? And then left us with more questions, because whatever, I forgot her name, Tania or whatever, all of a sudden's like, huh, well, my day will come one day. What is your problem, bitch? What is wrong with you? Really? What are you upset about? You're dead! As far as I'm concerned, you've been dead for hundreds of years! Why are you doing this? We didn't do nothing to you. The humans didn't do anything to you. You want to rule the world? Is that why? But there's no way for you to come out? I really don't understand what happened. This game could have been a lot better. And to be honest, I don't really care what happens now with Assassin's Creed. Good graphics, but I gotta tell you, I'm done with the Assassin's Creed. I'm done. I can't play this game anymore. It's the same gameplay. It's gonna be the same gameplay if they do Assassin's Creed, what? Connor 2 or something like that. Who knows what it is. But yeah. That's pretty much it. There's no reason. There's no reason for it. But what's going on here? Oh shit, it's an epilogue. Alright, maybe we'll have some more answers then. Now the manor is his. Oh, just relax now. You did this for nothing. Where's that tomahawk? I do have to say the music is really good, though. That I have to give them that. The music was really good. Score was really good. And this theme is really good. That was it? Oh wait a minute, there's a quest. What's going on here? Back to the frontier? Oh no, back to New York. Huh. Where? Alright, let's go find out what's going on.